here. I've had a question about training for the Snatch. The Tactical Strength Challenge is coming up, and it's super important that you're training your Snatch and making sure that you're really dialing in your form before you go test that very advanced skill. So I'm gonna go over a few tips and tricks to hopefully help clean up your Snatch technique and help you dial in that form before you go to the Tactical Strength Challenge. A good drill to start off with for the Snatch that I give a lot of my clients is working on their high pull. So you should have your single arm swing pretty dialed in at this point. Training your single arm swing, swinging really heavy, so pick a pretty heavy bell that you really have to control single arm, is going to really help with keeping the shoulder packed and making sure that you have enough power to get that bell up overhead. So the high pull is almost a snatch, but you end up really feeling where that float is going to be. One of the best kind of rhythms that you want to get in with your snatch is a pop, pull, punch. The snatch is basically a float up to 11 o'clock. If you think of a clock, this is going to be 12. You want to punch through on your snatch right at 11. So I like to open up my hand and punch through right at 11 o'clock. Keep the shoulder packed so that you end up at 12. People try and end up all the way at 12 and it ends up jerking their shoulder back. So you really do have to control it through the float phase and punch through at 11 o'clock so that you end up at 12 o'clock. So with your high pull, you're really trying to feel where that float is and control it during that float phase, because the next phase you're going to be punching through and catching it up at 12 o'clock. Make sure in your high pulls that you're still using your hips, locking out here, and then controlling the bell as it's floating into that final spot. You want your elbow to come up like you're pulling it into you. One of the little ladders that I really like to use to practice the snatch, at least building up to it, is cleans, swings, high pulls. Once you've worked on those clean swings, pattern the high pull so you really understand how to control the float in here. I like to start with the snatch up overhead. So I'm gonna get the bell up overhead, press. Now I'm gonna drop the bell. So I'm working on my down phase of my snatch. You're just working on dropping it. The biggest things from the top down is that the shoulder is staying packed up at the top. You also want to think of this little flip. So lead with the pinky as you dump the bell. It's not casting the bell out. You want to make sure that the bell is staying fairly tight into you. Imagine that you're in a telephone booth and you're literally having to snatch inside of a telephone booth. The biggest issue I see with people with the snatch is that they toss it way out in front of them, and now it's much harder to load the bell and to get it up overhead if you're way out in front. You actually want a bent elbow, almost like a little T-Rex elbow. So imagine you're inside of a telephone booth having to drop it. So up at the top, I'm gonna keep my ribs down. I'm gonna tip with my pinky here so that it goes. Let gravity do its thing. And I'm just staying in my lane here. So think of Mr. Miyagi painting the fence. That's literally how you should be snatching. So on the way down, it's pinky, paint the fence. So I'm staying in this lane, elbow is bent in here. And now I'm still locked out with my core. I can load it into my cylinder before snapping, painting the fence again. Elbow is bent. This is the float phase, right? High pull in here, and then punching through back at 11 before ending up back at 12. Those are the two biggest things that I see is people not loading enough into their hips. They turn it into an upper body pull, basically. And as you get going with these testing skills, you have to make sure that you're loading the hips enough to generate power to get as many snatches as possible in that allotted time, or to get up to 100 snatches. So I'll show you with the kettlebell. I'm gonna start up overhead. So clean, get up overhead. Make sure I'm nice and locked out. Shoulder is packed, my butt is squeezed, my quads are squeezed. I'm in a good tall standing plank. I'm gonna lead with my pinky up top. Paint the fence like Mr. Miyagi and make sure I'm loading my hips. I'm gonna pause again up at the top. Go through my checklist, get ready to dump. So just like we talked about in the down phase of the snatch, bending the elbow, pulling the belt into you a little bit, Mr. Miyagi, paint the fence. You're doing the same thing on the way up. You're controlling the float and that load to project the bell up overhead. The bell is wanting to go out, right? Because I'm loading my hips and projecting the bell that way. Now you have to pull that bell into you to get that trajectory to go up and end up overhead. So as I begin, I'm loading my hips, getting a good snap, staying inside of the telephone booth, pulling the belt into me, punching through at 11 to end up at 12. One of the things that people complain about the most when doing kettlebell work in general is that banging of the bell on your forearm. When you punch through at 11 o'clock, I want you to loosen up your grip just a little bit. You'll see some people open up their hands. I open up my hand just to make sure I'm punching through hard. That's personal preference, right? Loosen up your grip so that the bell will sneak and kind of slide around your hand and you won't get that banging. So I'm going to show you a couple snatches, and I want you to think of pop, pull, punch at 11 o'clock. Pop, pull, punch. Pop, pull, punch. Pop, pull, punch. You can see that pop, pull, punch at 11 happens very quickly. If I wait to punch through at 12 or try and catch it up at the top, that's where you get that kind of jarring of the shoulder. So as I punch through at 11, Now it finishes the float part at 12, and I can keep my shoulder packed and engaged. A couple key tips that really helped me and totally changed my life with the snatch was really keeping the elbow in your lane. So think of your right and left as these two lanes here. And this is where you want to be snatching. A lot of people will end up out here, out in like, call it the X. If you're catching it out here, you end up arcing basically, and kind of, it's much more difficult to control out here. Think of your elbow staying in the lane. So you're snatching right above. This elbow has to come into that center lane instead of out. So I'm focusing on my elbow staying in the lane and not as much of just the kettlebell. People will focus really, really hard on that kettlebell coming down. Make sure your elbow stays in the lane and tucked. Just like Mr. Miyagi painting the fence, stay inside of your telephone booth and keep your elbow tucked in. Make sure that you're really loading those hips. You've got to load to make sure that you can have enough power to get the bell up overhead. Stay in your lane, okay? So once you get up overhead, tip with the pinky, stay in your lane, paint the fence, and stay inside of your telephone booth to help load, okay? Also make sure that as you're loading, you have to wait, and then push behind you to help with that load. Snap, paint the fence, punch through at 11, end up at the top of your snatch. I hope some of those coaching tips help. Best of luck on your tactical strength challenge. You're gonna kill it.